Good morning, dear students. Today we will continue with our topic determiners. So today we are going to learn possessives and distributives. So let us start with possessives. Now what are possessives? See the words like my, our, their, your, his, her and its are possessives. Now, what do you mean by possessives? The words which shows the ownership or possession, they are called as possessives. Now, one paragraph is given. So, let us read that paragraph carefully. Sachin Tendulkar is a great cricketer. His coach started training him at an early age. He has played against many teams to win trophies for his country. All the players of his team practice regularly and their schedule is well planned. He often tells other players, "Our victory is possible because we always play as team." One of his fans once told him, "Your matches are always watched with great enthusiasm." So the words which are underlined, which are printed in bold, that is his, their, our and your, these are all possessives. What are these possessives? Because they show the possession. His coach. So, whose coach? Sachin Tendulkar's coach, right? His team, his country, right? Your matches. So, these all tell us about the possession. So, they are called as possessives. Now, possessives can be used with both countable as well as uncountable nouns. For example, the car is big. I think its color is too bright. Now, its means whose car's color, right? So, it shows the possession. Your books are not new. So, your, whose books? Yours. So, yours is possessives. Their school is closed. So, their school. So, these words which are bold, they are possessives, they show the possession. Next is distributives. Now what do you mean by distributives? Now the words like either, neither, each and every are called as distributives. So we use either to indicate any of the two persons or thing. So, any of two persons or things. Now, when we use either to indicate any of two, means from two, any one. So, to say that we use either. Okay. For example, you can use either pencil, any of the two pencils. Okay. Now, so you can use either pencil. Either pencil means any one pencil from two pencils. So, from two, if you want to refer to any one, we use either. Second example, either calendar can be kept on the table. So, either means any one calendar from the two calendars. Okay. Next, we also use either to refer to both the things or both the persons. So, it is also used to refer both things or both persons. For example, there are tall trees on either side of the street. Now, either side means both the sides. So, there are tall trees on both the sides of the trees. So, to indicate both, to refer both the things, also we use distributives. Let us see some more examples. We use neither to mean just the opposite of either. Now, neither is what? Opposite of either. It means not the one. It means what? Not the one, nor the other. Okay. means not this also, not that also. Example, neither team was well prepared for the match. So from two, not a single team was well prepared, right? Next, use of each. Each is used to indicate things separately, one by one. So indicate things separately, one by one, we use each. We use each when we refer to small number or when the group is limited and definite. So referring small number, group is limited or definite, at that time we use each. For example, each child was in proper uniform. Now here a small group of children is there in, and from that each child was in proper uniform. Okay, each member of the team was given a prize. Now here also there is a limited team, and in that each member was given a prize. Next, use of every. Every is used when we refer to things or persons as a group. To refer things or person as a group. For example, every student has got an identity card. It means the whole group has got the identity card. Every room has been painted. Every seat was occupied. So every is used to refer the things or persons as a group. So when we refer it as a group, we use every. We use every when the number of persons or things is large or indefinite. Number of persons or things is large or indefinite, whereas each is used for the number of groups which is limited and definite. So that is the difference between each and every. Each is used for small group, every is used for large group. Each is used for definite group, every is used for indefinite group. Okay, now let us move ahead with quantifiers. Quantifiers. So the words like any, some, much, many, several, a lot of, these all are called quantifiers because they show some quantity. Okay, so let us see how to use any and some. These determiners can refer to both quantity and number. So any and some can refer quantity or number. Okay, for example, some is used in affirmative and interrogative sentences. Now, some is used in affirmative and interrogative. Already you have learned what is affirmative sentence and what is interrogative sentence. Affirmative sentence which states something, it is also called as declarative sentence. Whereas interrogative sentence asks something, right? So some is used in affirmative and interrogative sentences. Let us see the examples. There is some money in my pocket. So this is affirmative sentence. Some children have come to meet you. This is also affirmative sentence. Do you have some money? This is interrogative sentence. So some is used in affirmative or interrogative sentences. Now let us see the use of any. Any is used in negative and interrogative sentences. Negative and interrogative sentences we use any. For example, I don't have any money to spare. Now you can see here this is negative sentence, don't have. So it is negative sentence. There isn't any milk in the pan. Isn't is negative word. So this is also a negative sentence. Don't you have any money in your pocket? This is interrogative sentence. It asks something, right? So, any is used in negative and interrogative sentences, whereas some is used in affirmative and interrogative. Some and any, both are used in interrogative sentences. And some is used in affirmative and any is used in negative sentence. Sometimes any is used to indicate that it does not matter which one or who. So any is also used to indicate that it does not matter which one or who. It doesn't matter. So for that purpose also we use any. Example, I will wear any dress in the evening. So any dress, right? It doesn't matter which dress, any dress. Next, let us read the sentences. Many buses play on the road. Many. She had to face a lot of problems. A lot of. So these underlined words, that is many, a lot of, these are what? These are quantifiers. Let us see some more examples. Some vendors have started selling goods near my house. I don't take much interest in TV serials. So these are what? These are all quantifiers. Now let us see the use of few, a few, and the few. Now few is used in a negative sense and with countable nouns. In a negative sense with countable nouns. Example, few persons were invited. Now few persons were invited. Few means what here? Hardly any. So this indicates negative sense. Hardly any, that is few. Next, a few means some, though not many. A few means some, not many. It is used in a positive sense. So see the difference. Few is used in negative sense, a few is used in positive sense. Example, I have read a few books on this topic. It means I have read some books on this topic. The number is less, okay? The few means all of them. The few means all of them, though very few in number. Even if the number is very few, among that all. To indicate that we use the few. I have read the few books that you gave me, okay? So the books which you have given me, few books, okay? So from that I have read, the few means all. So the books, some books, few books which you have given, from that I have read, the few means I have read all the books, all of them, okay? Now let us move towards our next slide. Use of little, a little, and the little. Like we saw the use of few, a few, and the few. Similarly, we use little, a little, and the little. Little is used in negative sense. As we saw that few is used in negative sense, little is also used in negative sense. And it means not much or hardly anything. Example, he has little knowledge on the subject. Now, little knowledge here means hardly any knowledge. Okay. Next, a little is used in a positive sense, meaning at least some or to some extent. A little, it is used in positive sense. It means some. Okay. For example, there is a little chance of success. So here there is a little chance of success means there is some chance of success. Next, the little means not much but all that there is. Not much but all that there is. It means the entire quantity though very little. For example, I spent the little money I earned. So now the quantity is little, but it tells about entire quantity. Now entire means all, whatever he has earned, he spent all that, and for that we use the little. Okay, now let us move ahead. Use of much and many. Much refers to quantity and is used with uncountable nouns. Much is used with uncountable nouns. Example, the news gave my mother much relief. Now news is uncountable. So with uncountable noun we use much. Many refers to number. Now see, much refers to quantity whereas many refers to number. Much is used with uncountable, many is used with countable nouns. For example, many supporters were celebrating the team's victory. Now supporters is a countable noun, so we have used here many. So much is used with quantity, many with number, much with uncountable, many with countable. I hope you have understood quantifiers, which shows the quantity. Now let's move to our next type, that is interrogatives. Now interrogatives means what? Question words, right? So for example, what, which, whose, these are called as interrogatives. These are interrogatives. So determiners which are used to ask questions are called interrogatives. They can be used before any kind of noun, before any kind of noun, and are words like what, which, whose, how many, and how much. So these are the words which can be used as interrogatives, determiners. Let us see some examples. Which basket will you carry? Whose bags are lying outside? What books have been distributed? Which vegetable is fresh? So the words which ask the questions, they are interrogatives. I hope you have understood the topic determiners. Thank you.